हेलो, हेलो, हाय गाइस, आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? ओके फाइन, देन वी कैन स्टार्ट क्लास। सो एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन और डाउट फ्रॉम यस्टरडेज क्लास? ओके, सो आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट वी आर गुड। सो ओके, सो आई थिंक यू गाइज आर एबल टू हियर मी एंड यू कैन सी माई स्क्रीन। सो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टूडेज क्लास। सो यस्टरडे वी कवर दैट हाउ टू क्रिएट ए डेटा सेट फ्रॉम इंटरनल डेटा और एक्सटर्नल डेटा, एंड वी कैन सी दैट हाउ वी कैन इम्पोर्ट एक्सटर्नल डेटा। फर्स्ट वी कैन यूज इम्पोर्ट विजार्ड, सेकेंड वी कैन यूज प्रॉप इम्पोर्ट, थर्ड वी कैन यूज इन फाइल स्टेटमेंट, एंड फोर्थ वन इज योर प्रॉक एसक्यूएल पास थ्रू क्वेरी व्हेन वी हैव टू फेच डेटा फ्रॉम सर्वर्स। सो बेसिकली टुडे आई एम टेकिंग आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दैट हाउ टू डेटा स्टेप प्रोसेस। ओके, सो हाउ इंटरनली योर डेटा एग्जीक्यूट्स, योर कोड एग्जीक्यूट्स एंड इट जनरेट्स द डेटा सेट। So normally each data step contains two phases. First one is your compilation and second is your execution phase. Okay? Yeah. So in compilation phase, basically it just check syntax error. So basically it will check all the such statements that your keywords are perfect or not. If keywords are not perfect, then it will just show you some errors. Okay, and the descriptive portion of SAS is just your properties of your columns. Your length, name, label, format, informat, and type. Okay, so main thing is that there are two major objects which contains in the compilation phase. First one is the input buffer and second one is your PDV. Okay, so PDV known as program data vector. The full form is PDV, is a program data vector. I just forget to write it here. So PDV is a program data vector. So basically PDV is your middleman. It takes data from the input buffer and just pass to the output buffer where it goes to create a SAS data set. So here is already mentioned. So program data vector is your logical area of memory, or you can say is a middleman which handles your data during your data step. Okay, so basically SAS reads data by one row by row. Okay, so basically first it reads the first observation or first row, and then it passes to your PDV, program data vector, and then program data vector just scan it that all the like character length, format, informat, type and all these properties are good or not, and then it passes to the output buffer where it goes for the created SAS data set. Okay, so program data vector contains permanent and temporary. Okay, permanent is just whatever the variables which you mention in the your input statement. Computed, it means where you can generating some new variables by using existing variables, just like C equal to A multiply B, A plus B. So computed variables option we will take later. Okay, and temporary. So there's a two major variables are there, underscore n underscore and underscore error underscore. So underscore n underscore will just give the row number, or you can say observation number. So which observation is running it? And underscore error underscore will tell you that if there is any error or not. Okay, so basically underscore n underscore is a row number which can be like, if you have a 10 rows, so it will run 10 times, so it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. But underscore error underscore contains only two values, either 0 or 1. 0 means error, 0 means no error, 1 means error. Like your data is not in proper order, or something is missing. Okay, so it contains only two values, 0, 1. 0 means no error, 1 means error. And some of the options are there, first dot by and the last dot by, in and end. So which we'll cover later. So basically program data vector is your major part of your processing. And in the next slide you will see, this is your execution phase. In the compile program, in the compilation phase, it will just read, go through your entire SAS code. Just check about that there is any syntax error or not. Okay, if not, then it goes to, so initialize variables to missing. So basically in your PDV, it generates all the variables. Just like in this case, you can see I have three variables. The first one is an employee number. Second one is your employee name, and third one is the department. And with these three variables is generating two more variables, underscore and underscore and error underscore error underscore. So basically here you can see, first it will initialize variable to missing. Okay, so first time it will be empty, so then it will read the first row. So the first row will come here, 10, Scott, marketing, and it's reading the first row, so this value will be 1 because this is the first row. So in this case there is no error, so this value is coming as a 0. Okay, so each and everything is fine, so then it will pass the first row to the SAS data set or output buffer. Then again it goes to missing, the entire thing will be the blank. You can see about that. First initialize variable to missing, execute input statement or if you have any other statement. Okay, then it checks the end of the file, no, then it will go to here, output to SAS data set, and just repeat the same process. So it will just read the data observation by observation. Okay, so by reading the first row, the first row goes to your cess data set, then it will read the second row, the 20 will come here, John, and the finance will come here, then this will be replaced with the 2. And again, if there is no error, everything is fine, your data is in proper order, character is fine, length is fine, format, informat, each one is fine, then again this value will be 0, then it will come to the again, come to the SAS data set. So in this way, it will read one by one. So finally, this will be your output. By default, this is automatic variables, which will not be displayed in your output data. Okay, so basically thing is that the main thing is your input buffer. Second thing is your PDB, which is called the program data vector, and third one is your SAS data set. So in this way, your data process through PDB and generate a SAS data set. So any question on it? Then I think we are good. So they can send me a test mail. I will just revert back this PPT with you guys. Okay, so I'm going to here. So we've already covered this one, data ABC. Okay, so we have taken like yesterday that if my data is in the character or the numeric, so here you can say about that here employee ID is your numeric and employee name is your character type. But sometimes what happens, like you are reading some unusual data. Unusual, it means you are reading dates, okay, or maybe you are reading some currencies, just like dollar value, pound, yen, or commas. So if such type of data is coming, then how to read the data? Okay, so basically then we use informat for read the data. and format, write the data. So let's assume that I have two variables is already there. Now the third one is the date of birth or joining date. So you can see about that, by default is taken the by default data type, which is numeric. So but you is treating just like as a character. So it replaced with the dot. Okay. So now the things are that now because this is some different format. So what we can use it here, we can use the in format to read the data. So basically the syntax of in format is this one. Okay, so informat is an instruction that says used to read data values when your data values are not in the proper order, just like dates, decimal values, commas. Okay, so one thing is that what you have to use is here, first thing is that your dollar indicates just like is a character informat or not. If you're not using dollar, then it will treat as a numeric one. Informat is your keyword. Okay, W specify the width and D specify the number of decimal points. So here you can see I'm using in format. Then the variable which I have to use in format. Then I have to use the what type of informat is there. So basically I am just taking the main informats which we generally use. Okay, this date 9. So 9 is your length here. So you can see here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, but here is a two digits are there, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, so when you run this one, you will get some numbers. Why? Because SAS stores date in form of numbers. Okay, so what this number is there? So basically SAS has set a value. Just 1 minute. Search that value. This is 1st Jan 1960. So basically it will take the difference between these two dates. The number is representing here like 7898. It is a difference between your existing date minus your 1st Jan 1960. It is 17,898. And again, same thing you see here, just like you said, 10 Feb 2010. Okay. If some values are less than 1960, then your this number will be negative side. Now assume that it's a 1950. Then it will give the minus number, negative number. So here, if you use 1950. You get a negative number. Okay, but in the real time scenario, you have to convert these numbers into again a date format. Okay, so what we can do it, if you want, we can use the same stuff. We have to use the format. Format we use for the write the data in date format, comma, again same thing. In format is for the reading and format is for the writing. So I am using the same thing. So here you can see now format and the informat. Date 9 dot, this is date 9 dot. Okay, if you want to change some different informat, because one thing is that informat you cannot set. You have to use as your data exists. Okay, but format if you want you can change by your own side. So one thing is that which is DD MM YY 10 dot. So now it's coming like this one. 1st Jan 2009, 10 Feb 1950. So if you want something 8, you want to remove the century, then you can use the 8. Now your century is not coming. So this thing you can set by your side. Okay. And again, then this stuff is there just like you have a salary part is there, which is containing dollar amount. So again same thing. Again it's not able to read the salary part. So again we have to use the in format. So in this case you have to use salary. So in this case you have to specify like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. It should be 8.2. Because you are containing 2 decimal points. Okay, so if you run this one. One minute. So here you can see that like this time I am not able to read data in proper format, that's reason the value of underscore error underscore is 1 and this is the first line. So you can see salary is not able to is taking the dot. Employee ID is taking the 101. Employee name is a Gaurav. This is the basically it's your and joining it. Basically this is your PDV. How is just processing data one by one? So first it has taken this data, then it just moved to your PDV, then it just throws the output data. So this is your output. So here you can see like joining date is coming properly, salary is not coming, employee ID is fine, and this is the Gaurav, and here you can see this is the value to one, and this is the first row, and similarly here for second row. Okay, I think what's the problem is there. Just one minute. Oh, sorry. I just forgot to mention dollar. Okay, so now you can see some values are coming. Okay, but again, it's not coming in the dollar format. So what you can do it? In format, you can specify salary. So now it's containing the comma and dollar both. Okay, so I am trying to cover the basics. Basically, I am not telling this is the only informant. There is a lot of informant in the formats are there. I will take examples also one by one. I am just going the basics to assume that you have another thing is there, which is the bonus. And which it does not contain dollar, it just is a comma value, just like 1500, or you can just take it as a CTC. So now if you have to read this data again, you have to change the thing. Comma. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. You have to specify the maximum length. So this is nine, but I am making it a 10. So in this case, there is no decimal point is there, though I am not mentioning anything for the decimal points. And same thing for the format to write the data. Just 1 minute. Oh, just sorry, I just forgot in the here. Input statement. Okay, so here you can see. So any doubt for this informant and format? Basically, I will take some examples also, but this is the basics that how to use informant and the format. So I told you that basically SAS stores dates in the form of numbers, and the number is your difference between your existing date minus your first year 1960, And first Jan 1960 we call it a sales date value, which you can use as reference date. So if basically the difference between number of days from your existing date to your sales date value, which is first Jan 1960, if its value is less than first Jan 1960, then the number will be negative side. So SAS stores dates in the form of numbers internally. Okay, so sometimes we ask in the interview also that what is the data type of dates? It's a numeric. And salary is the dollar value, or maybe any currency we can use it. In the comma part, by default it's a numeric one. But things are there like comma is coming and dollar value is coming. So SAS is not able to read those values directly. So we use the informal and format. So when you go to the output data, you can see the properties here. Like numeric, format, informat. You can see this one, and you can take the joining date. So where you can see that informat is a date 9 dot. And format is EDMMYY 8 dot, and 8 is your length. Okay, any doubt? Because I am taking some of the examples for informat and the formats. So here I am just showing the basics, that what is the use of informat and format. So basically informat and format we use only for the dates, currency values, and if you are getting some comma values. Okay, so any doubt, any question? Now, then I am going for the example session, where we can see different types of format and informats. Just go through it. I am giving 2 minutes. Hello. Yeah, so anyone has any question or doubt? Are we good? Okay, fine. Then I'm assuming that we are good. Okay, so I'm just showing some of the examples of the first informat and then for the format. Okay, so first, okay, so I'm just taking some character informats. Okay, So basically, I already have shown the description. Okay, so this is the character. Okay, so dollar I am specifying because this is the character in format. Okay, char is your character in format name, and 12 is your length width. So basically, in this case, it doesn't trim the leading or trailing blanks. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Thank you.
Hello. Yeah. So here I'm just talking some of the character informant. So informant is just a name of data set. Okay, you can just want, you can replace by your own side. Okay. So input. So sometimes if you want, you can just mention your informant in your input statement itself. Or if you want, you can just make a separate statement also. Okay, so basically this one, basically I'm mentioning dollar because this is the character in format. Char is the name of your format and 12 is your length. So basically when it's reading the data, it doesn't trim your leading or trailing blanks. So once you will run this one and you will print it, you will just see the difference. Okay, the second one is that your dollar W. So basically it reads your character data and trims your leading blanks. Okay, and third one is your up keys. Basically it just converts your data into the upper case. So you can see your names are coming in the upper letter. The fourth one is your quote. So basically it just removes quotation marks from your data. So here you can say this is a quote, it's showing the quotation marks. So quote will just removes quotation marks. Now it's only names are coming, the quotation marks are not coming. So these are the some of the character informant. So now let's go for the numeric informant. So I think we already discussed comma. Okay, so basically comma just read the commas and along with it also convert your left parenthesis to minus sign. Okay, so basically here you can see I'm using all these things, dollar, comma, this is your left parenthesis, this is your exponential format, and this is your percentage. So if you just run this one, so you can see the difference. 2e5, it just converted into the numbers. Here again is the number 13. Left parenthesis converted into the minus sign and it removes the commas and the dollar values. Okay, because in this case we are only reading the data. Okay. So if anyone has any doubt, they can stop me because in this program, I already shown you that how to use informat and format and what is the use of informat and format. Here I am just showing some of the examples one by one for different types of informat like character, numeric or date. Cacti is already covered, and now I'm moving to numeric in format. This is the comma. I told W is specified the width, and D is your decibel point. So in this case, there is no decibel point, so I did not specify any decibel points here. Okay. And then again, percent. So basically, percent convert percentage to numbers. Here you can see is 0.13, 1.00, 0.27, and left path, this is converted into the minus, and it's is point minus 0.20. So I think already covered this that what is the difference between format and format, but I'm taking it again. In format is reading data and format writing data. So basically, just assume that you have a joining date, which is date, a salary, which is containing dollar value and commas, your CTC, which is containing only this one. Okay, so your by default SAS is not able to read this data. Okay, so what we use in format. So again, in format is for reading the data. So you can see your joining in format is your keyword. Joining DOB, it can variable name. So this is your variable name here. Okay, so you have to look out that, okay, this is the in format is date 9 dot. Okay, salary is $10.2. So your 10 is your width and 2 is your decibel points. Here is comma and 10 is your width. So when you will just run this one, I am just using only in format. So you can see like joining date of birth is containing some negative some numbers. Okay. Same thing with salary also, it doesn't contain any dollar value and commas. And same thing with the CTC also. Okay, so I already covered what is this number. This number is a difference between your existing date and your sales date value, which is 1st Jan 1960. Like 1st Jan 1960 and this second value 10 Feb 1950. So difference between these 2 dates, this representing by this number. Okay, so again we have to write in a proper standard format. So I'm using the format statement to writing my data, because in formats you cannot set by yourself. You have to set as per your data is there. Like you cannot change this form in formats of it. You have to specify, but things are that format means you are writing your data, which you can change. So in format is your date 9 dot, but here I'm using DDMMYY 8 dot. Like salary, some other currency you can use it. We are using $10.2. CTC again, same thing. If you want, you can just some. If you want something, you can make it a dollar. So now your joining date is coming in the DDMMYY format. So you can just see the length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is the length. You can just look out the salary is coming in this format, dollar and the comma, along with the decimal points, which is I already mentioned too. CTC is also coming in the dollar because I changed the in format here. When I'm reading is a comma, but when I'm writing is a dollar value. Okay, is it clear or any doubt? Okay, fine. So I think we are good. So I'm again moving to our example session. So first I'm only covering informats. So I am again continuing this one. So this is the percentage. So simple thing is that this converts your percentage values to the numbers. So here you can see it's like 0.13, 1.00, 0.27, and this is, we are using the left parenthesis, so it will convert into the minus sign and 0.20, this value. Okay, now let's go to date part. Okay, so this is very important one. Okay, you can see it here, I'm using informat the date 9 because it's 9 is your this one, where first 2 is your DD date, the next 3 is your month name and your first 3 letters, and then your year. So you can see some numbers are coming. I already given that there's numbers are the difference between your existing date with your first gen 1960. The fourth value will be the first gen 1960. You can see that the value are coming as a zero. Okay, the next one is your DDMMYY. Okay, it contains 8 and 10. So in this case you can see we are using hyphen dot slash, but things are that the first two values are taking the DD is your date value, fourth and fifth is your month number, and 7 or 8 is your year. So when you run this one again, you will get some numbers, same numbers, because we are using the same values. If your year contains your century also, then your width goes increase. Now your width is 10. Okay, so again, the numbers, this is a difference between your existing date to your first gen 1960 value. So basically I am just trying to cover the main part, main informats and the formats which you generally use. Another type is your month, MON and YY, where you are just first 3 letters is showing your month and next 2 is your year. Okay, so in this case your date is not mentioning, so it will just refer your first. So yeah, this value will be like first Jan 1960, first Jan 1961, first December 1960, and first December 1961. Okay, so these are some of the basic informats are there. Okay, now similarly I am just trying to take some formats. So again, there is a small difference is there. I already told you, in format is just for the reading the data, and format is just for writing the data. Okay, in format you have to set as per your data, as per your values of your columns or variables. But format you can set by your side because you are writing the data. Okay. Okay, so now I am coming in the format. But things are that before format you have to use the in format because you are reading the data. Okay, so in this way you can see that I am getting the quotation. So this is my in format. Okay, so and this is my format which I already specifying it. Okay, so basically you can see the first thing is the format we use to write data values. Again, same thing. Dollar is specified as a character or non-character. Means character or numeric is a dollar. It means is a character. Format you have to specify your format name. Okay, just like quote.
We are not able. We, hello.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, I'm. We are not able to see your screen.
Sorry.
Yeah, now we can see.
Sorry.
Okay, and there's one more thing, like at the right corner of your screen, that is coming a like a rectangular size of black screen at the some part of your right corner.
Now
yeah,
it's fine.
It's good now. Yeah, it's good now.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Okay, fine. So now I'm coming some of the examples of format. Okay, so format is just for write your data values. Okay, the same similar thing. The syntax is same. Dollar. You have to specify it's a character format or not. Format you have to specify your format name. W is your width. And D is your number of decimal points. So here, this is my in format because first I have to read the data, and then using format I have to write the data. Okay. So once I will run this one. You can see the entire thing is coming in the quotation marks. Okay. Now you have some numbers. In this case, I am not using any in format because my data is in the standard numeric format. But I want to use some comma or dollar. First, I am using the comma. I am specifying the length, width, and the decimal points. You can see the comma is there. The same thing we can the dollar. So now the it will just show your dollars with the it will show the values in the dollar format. like dollar and along with the comma. Now I'm moving to the date format. Okay, so here you can see about that. First I'm reading, so I'm using in format, and then I'm just writing it. So basically your width. Okay, so basically when I'm using this one, it's coming like 1st Jan 1987. But if I reduce the length, now I reduce the length, now make it as a 7, then it will just remove the century. It will contain only the year. So I already told you, this is my in format which I cannot change because my data is coming in this format. So I have to set format as per my data, but things are that format I can change it from my own side. Okay, so now next thing is that just like that, here I am, in format is a date 9, but things are that format is my DDMMYY. Ten dot. You can see here. Okay, I am reading data in format, this is date 9, but when I am writing the DDMMYY format. Here again I just reduce the length, now is 8. It just reduce your, now it's not showing your century, it's just showing only the year. So if you want, you can just change it like MMDDYY format also. Now it's coming in the MMDDYY format. Here it's showing as a date 9 format in format, but when you do a format, it's coming like MMDDYY format. One another format is their week date. Basically in this case it will just give the day of the week in the form of week, number, month, name, DDYY, each and everything. Okay, so basically when you just run this one, it just showing you the week day name, month name, date value along with the year. Now you using the theme format, but things are that you just reduce the length. Now you're using only the 9, so you can see the difference. Now you're just showing only your week, it's a Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. So in this way, so this is the one another way to just convert your data using format. like you are getting data in the form of a dates. If someone say about that, I have to fetch week, then we can use a format statement to fetch the week by using this format. Again, if you will change the length again, previously it was first I used 30, okay, second I will use a 9, now I am using the 15. So now we can see about that, still is showing your week name, your month name, but in the shorter format. Okay, so basically you are using only the same format name, but things are that when you change the length, your output will also differ. So basically it depends your requirement that how wanna you show your values in your data set or in your result. So based on your analysis or based on your requirement, you can just change your length. Okay, and it's not like that you can just set any length. This is a specified length to get a proper output. Okay, because in this case I am just giving example. Okay, because there are the thousands of informat and formats are there. So basically it depends on your requirement. So again here I am using like week date 29, again you will get some different value. So when we are not specifying anything, any width, then you just give the week number. To represent Monday. Okay, if it's just like this, 25th, then the value will be 1, because on 25th 1987 contains Sunday, and Sunday it takes as a 1. Or you want to test it with a different value, you can just make it as a 28. Now it will take a 4. Okay, so this is another way to get your day of the week. Okay, the same thing here, if you are interested only for the day, you can use the day 2 dot, it will just display only your day number, like 26. So these are some of the examples of some different types of informat and formats. So just go through it. Send me a test mail. I will just share this course with you. So you can just go through it. If you have any problem with that, then you can reach out to me. Okay, so I am just giving again 2 minutes. Just go through it. So if you have any problem, then we can discuss on it, and then we'll go for the next topic. Okay.
Thank you.
Hello. Yeah, so I have covered some examples of informal and format, and here I'm just I have shown you that how to use informal and format. So again, I'm repeating that informal is just for reading the data and format is just for writing the data. There is simple straightforward difference between these two. One is for the reading, second is for writing. And this we use when our data is not in the standard format. In the standard format, you can say about that non-standard format is just like that dates, currency values, or commas, which we generally get in the, our real-time scenario. Okay, so basically when you are working with the prop import or import wizard, or when you are fetching data from servers, there's three methods automatically handle your informal and format. So basically what these three option does, basically this just scan your entire data. So based on your scanning, they just set your formats and the informats. Okay, while we are working with the infile statement, then you have to specify informal and format to read your data. Okay, so that's one of the reason we always prefer to use proc import, import wizard, or we can use proc SQL or pass through query when we are fetching data from servers. So basically when you are working in the real time scenario, you cannot scan entire data, because in this case you can see you have only two rows. So based on the scanning, you can just figure it out what it can, what type of informat can be, or what type of format you have to set. Okay, so you can specify the length and the decibel points and each and everything you can set. But in the real time scenario is very tough. Okay, so that's reason we use import wizard, proc import, and pass through query rather than infile statement. Okay, so here we already covered, I had covered some of the examples of informal and the formats, which will I will share you tonight or maybe on tomorrow morning. You can just send me a test mail on my mail ID. I will revert back with these codes. Okay, so anyone has any questions, or we can move to the next topic? Okay, fine. So I think we are good. So if anyone has any doubt regarding quotes or if anyone has any query, so they can reach out to me on my mail ID. I think I already shared my mail ID to each and everyone like that. And if you want, I can share it again. Okay, so now we are moving to the next topic. Just give me one moment. Okay, so till now we are working with the existing columns or existing data. So now I'm taking a topic then when we create new variables, maybe from our existing variables or maybe as a constant value. Okay, so assume that you have a data set, is a data, is a employee, and you have a 2 and 3 variables. First is employee ID. Or second you can say is salary, employer name which is a dollar value, and salary is there. So this is the simplest example where you are getting the three columns. and three variables: employee ID, employee name, and salary. Now someone will ask you that, okay, just create one more variable, which is a bonus, and bonus is your 10% of your salary. Okay, so basically here you cannot make it as a salary. It's already existing one, and from salary you have to make it the bonus. So what you can do is you can create in one more variable. It's called the bonus is equal to salary multiply with the 0.1. So here you can see salary and the bonus is your new variable which is you generated from salary. So basically bonus you are not specifying in your input statement because you are not reading from your data. Okay, so bonus is the variable which you are creating. Okay, so basically employee ID, employee name, and salary, these three variables are user defined variables. Okay, and bonus is the variable which you computed by from user defined variables or you are from existing data set variables. Okay, so if you want that bonus is a constant value, it's just like it's 100 for each and everyone, you can specify the 100. So like all the bonus, all the guys will set bonus 100 rupees. So in this way you can assign a constant value also. It's not like that you can assign only single value. If you want, you can assign more than two and three variables also. Just like make it again salary is 10% of it. Now you can do the revised salary is a new salary, which is equivalent to your salary plus bonus. So now your niece new salary is salary plus bonus is coming like 1000 plus 100 is a 1100. 3000 plus 300 is a 3300. 3500 plus 350 is 3850. And another thing is that it's not like that you can just use only numeric. If you want, you can use some character constant also. Just assume that it's a department, and your department is your marketing. So here you can say I just mentioned a character constant here, and this you can see only employee ID, employee name, and the salary. There's three variables which is a user defined: bonus, new salary, and department is a computational which is created by my side or by user. So here you can see bonus is your 10% of salary and your new salary is your salary plus bonus. So in this way you can use any mathematical operation. Here I'm using summation, here I'm taking the multiplication, here I'm assigning a constant value. One small difference is that when you are assigning any date constant, okay, then you have to specify D. Just I'm showing it here. So you can see about that the its values are coming in the numbers. Then for this you have to specify format. So you can see it's a 18 August 2016. So basically, so when you are using character, sorry, date constant, then you have to specify D in the postfix along with the quotation mark. Okay, so anyone has any doubt or any question regarding it? This how to create new variables, maybe some existing variables, or maybe passing some constant values, maybe character constant or date constant. So basically here I am selected all these variables. So here you can see, so basically date is my date constant here. A date constant should be in a quotation mark along with the D as a postfix. When you are passing a date constant, okay. When you're passing a character constant, again you have to specify in the quotation marks, okay. And bonus, which is you are generating a 10% of salary, new salary is your salary plus bonus. So in this case, you can see only three variables. I'm reading, so there are three variables I mentioned in the input statement. Format, because the date should be specified some format, otherwise it will take the numbers. Okay, so when you just go for the output data, first your employee ID, employee name and the salary, there's three characters which we are reading from our data. Date is our date constant, okay, which is 18 August 2016, okay. So I'm writing in this format, so it's coming like this one. If you want, you can change it again, like date 9 dot, date 7 dot, MMDD, YY, 10 dot, any format as per your requirement. And bonus, which is 10% of your salary, the salary, and just 1 minute, yeah, salary and 10% is a bonus. A 10% of your salary is 100 300 and 350 based on your salary, okay. New salary is your bonus plus salary. Salary plus bonus is your new salary. Okay, and department is just again as a character constant, which I specify is a marketing here. Okay, so in this way we are creating new variables by using existing variables, or we can just pass some of the character or date or numeric constant. Okay, so when you are passing numeric constant, then no need to use any quotation mark. You can specify directly here, just like that. You use bonus equal to 100, So this is your numeric constant. Okay, so in this way we can just create new variables in our existing data set or using existing variables. Okay, so that's it for today. Okay, I'm just giving 5 minutes to just go through the entire session. Okay, so if you have any problem regarding format, informat, or creating new variables, then we can just go through it. And otherwise I'm going to wrap up for today. Then tomorrow we will just cover functions, different character functions and numeric functions. Okay, so I'm giving 5 minutes, just go through it. And if you want these codes, send me a mail. I will revert back with these codes along with the book I have, which is a little SAS book you can get from the net also. If you're not able to get it, and I can give it to you, it's a very nice book. You can use it for as your reference. Okay. Thank you. Hello guys. So anyone has any doubt? Or we are good? Okay, fine. So I'm just going to wrap up it for today. Okay, good night, guys. Thank you.